Okay, the search and reporting app is the default app that provides an interface for you to search, analyze, and visualize your data. So let's say that you, after Splunk installation, you were able to index some data in your instance, and then you wanted to search that data. So the search and reporting app is the default app that is going to permit you to do that. Let's look at the sections of the search and reporting app. The first one we're going to look at here is the search bar. That is where you actually specify your search criteria. And the second section here is the app navigation bar. So this app navigation bar shows views in your application. So if you have dashboards that you've created within the app, alerts that you've created within the app, reports, then you can access those through the app navigation bar. And then we have the time range picker. The time range picker, what it does is just to specify the time period of your search. So you can search historically back, like here, the default is 24 hours, but you can go as far back depending on the retention of data in your environment. Then you note that you can also search in real time. So search as the data is coming into Splunk. The other thing here is the search mode. Actually, you have three search modes. The first mode is the fast mode. In this mode, your searches are gonna complete faster, which means they are more performant, but it's gonna have less information. And then the next one is the smart mode. It's gonna be a little less performant compared to the fast mode, but it's gonna have a little bit more information as well compared to the fast mode. And then the next one is the verbose mode. So this one gives you all the data that you want, but it's slower. So it's the least performant of all the three search modes. Now you have the search history as well. So when you're running searches, it's keeping a history of those searches, because you could come back and then maybe you want to execute a search that you already ran before. You don't really have to write it. You can go into your search history and just pick that search from there and rerun the search. And then how to search just provides you links to the search manual and search tutorial. So when you click on those links, it's going to go to Splunk documentation online, where you can see the search manual there, which is going to have, you know, different commands that you're using. And of course, there is a search tutorial online as well, which is helpful for you. And then you have the data summary here. You want to know information about your environment. The data summary is going to give you information about host sources and source types that you have. So a little bit more about the data summary here. As we said, if you want to quickly learn about the data that is present in your environment, you use the data summary tab. So when you click on that tab, what's going to happen is that it's going to show you the count of events by host, sources, and source types, as you see here. So that presents you a complete view of your environment. And it's also going to show you, you know, the last time that each of those host, sources, and source types was updated. So here we are connected to our local instance of Splunk, and this is a search and reporting app. I'm just going to click here to navigate to the search and reporting app. And once you're here, there are multiple things that you can see. The first thing we're going to look at is the search bar. So this is where you're going to enter your search criteria. I have some data index in this environment that we're going to use along the course. So I'm just going to go to that data. So I'm going to go to source type, because event gen. I type run this. So I'm running this for the last 24 hours, because my time picker is still at default. You see that it's actually taking some time to pull that data for me. Right, but you see that I already have events that are coming through from this index. Of course, I used the main index. I didn't create a new index, because the main is the default index, as we saw before. And then I put the data in source type event gen. And now if I see like this, you know, maybe I just want to pull it for the last 60 minutes. I can go here and say, I just want to do last 60 minutes. So I use my time picker to do that. So you can use the time picker to go as far back as you like. You want to go last 30 days. As long as you have data there, you can do last 30 days. It can do that for you as well. Now, one thing I'm going to do, I will go back here to last 24 hours, which is our default. And then I will go here to fast mode. Remember, we spoke about the three different search modes, which are the fast mode, the smart mode, and the verbose mode. And then we say that the fast mode is the fastest, actually, in terms of performance, but it pulls less data. So if I go to the fast mode and I'm pulling this data for the last 24 hours, you see it's going to complete quickly. But if you look on this side, you're not going to see all the fields, because field discovery is not active. We're going to revisit this along the course. And then the second one here, you have the smart mode. So if I'm running that in smart mode, it's going to be less performant, but you see field discovery is active. So it's going to pull a lot more fields here, but at the expense of being less performant compared to the fast mode. And in the verbose mode, as we said, is the least performant of all the three search modes. Now here at the top is our app navigation bar that we saw. So you can go here to dashboards to see dashboards that you have created within this app itself. There is this dashboard that I already created here. So we are going to reproduce this dashboard as we go along. Let me just see if it pulls our information here. Yes, so this is the information that is associated with that dashboard. So you can also, access your alerts using the app navigation bar here. So this is an alert that I think we're going to create as well. And then your reports are going to be here. So that's how you use the app navigation bar, just to show the views that are available in your app. Now let's go back here. And then the next thing we're going to look at is the search history. So if you come here under search history, it's going to load the search history for you. Right now, by default, it has no time filter here, but you can actually filter. And you look at searches that you have run in your environment recently. So if I wanted to just rerun this search, index equals main and source type equals event gen, what I can do is just go here and say add to search, and then I run it. So it's going to rerun that search for me. So if you really do not remember how you this query that you use for a specific search, and you think it's going to take you a lot of time to craft that, you can always go back to your search history and pick it from there again. And then the last thing that we're going to look at is how to search. We go back here and we go under how to search, as we saw here. So this is going to take you to Splunk documentation. And this is actually going to take you to the search manual. And then if you use the tutorial here, that one's going to take you to the search tutorial. So you can follow this tutorial along as well to help you, see how you can write searches. And then if I go back here, the other thing we saw is the data summary. So when you click on the data summary, what it's going to do is just give it some time. It's going to load the data that you have in your environment. So it's going to show you the different hosts and then, the count of data in your host and the last time was updated. If you go to the source, you're going to see the sources as well that you have in your environment. And here, of course, the different source types. And note that the data is being provided to you using three fields: host, source, and source type.